In this video, we are counting down our top 10 comics on a $50 budget. Stay with us. Hey everybody, my name's Drew Stewart, and if we're just meeting, I'm the owner of Como Comic Books. We are a Columbia, Missouri-based comic book vendor, and on our YouTube channel, we focus on bringing you the best tips and tricks that will help you take your comic collection to the next level. In today's video, we're taking a formula we've applied previously in some of our earlier top 10 lists, where we gave you the top 10 comics to buy on a $20 budget, or the top 10 comics to buy on a $100 budget. And today, we're hitting the middle ground. We are going for that $50 sweet spot and bringing you our current list of our favorite books that you can pick up for right around 50 bucks. Some of the books on this list will be a little under 50 bucks. We're going to mention a couple of variants for books that are right around that $50 mark that may be just over. But for the most part, if you're walking around with a $50 bill in your pocket, chances are you're going to be able to pick up anything we talk about in this video today. Hey guys, stick around to the end of this video where I will reveal a bonus 11th comic you can get on a $50 budget. So let's go ahead and get into the list. In the number 10 spot is Usagi Yojimbo number 1. Published in July of 1987, this is the first solo outing for Usagi Yojimbo, who first appeared in Albedo number 2. This story is written by Dennis Fujitaki with art from Stan Sakai. Albedo number 2 is incredibly hard to track down. There weren't a lot of copies printed of it, and the people who have most of the remaining copies of Albedo number 2 rarely let them go. It's pretty rare to see a transfer of Albedo on eBay, even in some of the larger auction houses. It's a book that just does not come up for sale very often. To counteract that, fans are starting to flock to the much more accessible Usagi Yojimbo number 1. In the number 9 spot is Omega Men 3. This issue features the first appearance of Lobo. Published in June of 1983, Lobo has gone on to become a fan favorite character and is considered in many circles to be DC's answer to Wolverine. Written by Roger Slifer with art by Keith Giffen, I think this is a good issue to speculate on, as HBO Max is really diving deep into DC's pool of characters. Lobo is a character that you routinely hear about projects being started, but they never quite get past go. In the number 8 spot is Umbrella Academy from Free Comic Book Day 2007. This Free Comic Book Day giveaway features the first appearance of the Umbrella Academy team, and this book features the highest return on investment of any book on the list. If you picked this up when it originally came out, it literally cost you nothing, and today a copy will run you about $50. The Umbrella Academy Free Comic Book Day issue was written by Gerard Way and features art by Gabriel Ba. Coming in at the number 7 spot is Uncanny X-Men 221. Published in September of 1987, this story from Chris Claremont with art from Mark Silvestri features the first appearance of Mr. Sinister. With Disney and Marvel gaining the rights to the X-Men back from Fox, X-Men characters are a great area to speculate on. To go along with that, it's not an unreasonable assumption to think that Disney and Marvel may approach the X-Men a little bit differently than what they've been done before. You may not have Magneto as your primary villain. You may see Disney and Marvel give a villain like Magneto a rest. And at that point, you're looking at who can step into the role of the main villain for the X-Men. And Mr. Sinister is a leading candidate for that. This book continues to be fairly affordable, coming in right around $40. And I think it'll be a great addition to your collection and a great book to speculate on once the X-Men universe gets up and rolling within the Marvel Cinematic Universe. In the number 6 spot, we have Scalped number 1. Published in June of 2007, this book gets a little local love as series writer Jason Aaron lives right down the road in Kansas City, and this issue was illustrated by Jock. As we mentioned with Omega Men 3, HBO Max is developing many DC and Vertigo characters into series, and Scalp seems like a great fit for what they're setting up over at HBO Max. With that in mind, coming in right at $50, Scalped number 1 is definitely a book I would get on my short list. And the number 5 spot is Captain America number 6. Published in June of 2005, this features the first appearance of Bucky Barnes as the Winter Soldier. The 2005 series of Captain America is one of my absolute favorite comic stories from the last 10 to 15 years. Ed Brubaker and Steve Epting did amazing work in their time on that book. With the Falcon and Winter Soldier show on Disney Plus in development, the Winter Soldier is going to continue to be in the public eye and hopefully will continue to build a fan base, which will help drive value in this book in the future. The main A cover will run you about $40, and there's also a variant cover which features the Winter Soldier that will run you about $60. In the number 4 spot of our top 10 comics to buy on a $50 budget is Doorway to Nightmare number 1. This issue features the first appearance of Madame Xanadu. Published in February of 1978, Madame Xanadu makes her first appearance in this first issue of a title most people have never heard of. With all of the interest in Justice League Dark, that more mystical side or darker side of the DC Universe, the fact that most people are overlooking Madame Xanadu is a major opportunity to get in on the ground level of a book that could really blow up. We've all seen what's happened with Hawkman 4 in the last several months and years. Right now, a high-grade copy of Doorway to Nightmare number 1 is only going to set you back $35 for a major character's first appearance. Madame Xanadu seems to be flying below the radar right now, and I think this book has great potential in the future. Doorway to Nightmare 1 was written by Dave Michelinie, and it was drawn by Michael Kaluta. In the number 3 spot is Inhumans number 5. Published in March of 1999, Inhumans number 5 features the first appearance of Yelena Belova, the new Black Widow. It's been reported that the director of the Black Widow movie has stated that this version of the Black Widow will be an ongoing character in the Marvel Universe. And that is why you've seen this previous dollar bin book now jump up to where it is a $50 comic. Written by Paul Jenkins with art from Jay Lee, this book may still be in dollar bins out there in the wild. Keep an eye out for it. This character is going to be around for a while. In the number 2 spot is Fables number 1. This book was published in July of 2002 and is the first appearance of the Fables. What the Fables are classic literary characters that are now living in the real world. Written by Bill Willingham with art from James Jean, not only is this book a great read, I think this whole series is one of the best long-form stories available in the medium. This is another story that would be prime for the taking for development for an HBO Max series. This would appeal to viewers and readers that are more interested in a fantasy-based story and could really go a long way to diversify some of the material that HBO Max is developing. The standard A cover is going to run you right around $50, but there is a variant cover from Alex Maleev. That's my personal favorite. It's going to cost you $15 more. It checks in at $65 right now. In the number 1 spot, the top of the list, is Web of Spider-Man 118. This issue features the first appearance of Ben Reilly, the Spider-Man clone, as the Scarlet Spider. Written by Terry Cavanaugh with art from Stephen Butler, this issue is only going to run you about $30 right now, but the Scarlet Spider is a character we haven't seen show up yet in the Edge of Spider-Verse. As they continued to develop the Edge of Spider-Verse story, all of these different iterations of Spider-Man are bound to show up, including everyone's beloved clones from the 90s. In my opinion, this November 1994 release is a prime candidate to show up in a future Edge of Spider-Verse movie. The styling of the Scarlet Spider character is very simple, but very iconic. I think it would be a real missed opportunity if the Scarlet Spider never made its way into Edge of Spider-Verse. So while you've seen the first appearances of other Edge of Spider-Verse characters, Spider-Man Noir, Silk, Miles Morales, Spider-Gwen, peaking at prices of $100, $150, $250, $400 a piece, there are still several iterations of Spider-Man or variations on the Spider-Man character that are affordable. Our bonus book is The Old Guard number one. The Netflix adaptation of The Old Guard has just been released and has been received really well on the platform. Released in February of 2017, written by Greg Rucka with art from Leandro Fernandez, The Old Guard is going to set you back $30 for issue number one right now. With word of mouth on the movie just starting to get out, interest in this book is just starting to take off. I would get on this book sooner rather than later, or you might miss your opportunity. It's now time for our comments of the week, where we show appreciation to members of our community who have taken the time to leave us comments on any of our previous videos. This week, I want to thank Marcus Santiago, Daniel Rodriguez Jr., and Jenny Linzel. A sincere thank you to the three of you for taking the time to watch our videos, hopefully to like them, and to leave us a comment. We really appreciate your feedback. And Daniel, don't worry, we've got more content coming. The trouble with top 10 lists is that you can never fit everything on them. So with that in mind, let us know in the comments what book or books you would have added to your own top 10 comics for a $50 budget. If you got value out of the video today, be sure to hit that like button, share the video out on your social media accounts. Just let your friends know what we're doing over here at the Como Comic Books YouTube channel. We're going to continue to bring you the best tips and tricks to help you take your comic collection to the next level. We will see you all in the next video.